Merry Christmas to you. Today we celebrate that He is here. The Savior has been born and God is with us. I know it's a little strange that we're not together, but we are together in spirit. And I invite you to participate in this service. So here's a few things that you're going to need in order to do this service together. So you'll need to find 5 candles that you could put up and a lighter and someone to light the candles as indicated as we go through the service. So we're going to put the screen on pause right now so you can go and get ready. And then just know that at certain points, be ready to sing along. And at other points, be ready to pause the screen and answer the questions or the comments that are put together so that we can share together in the joy of this great coming of God and in the hope of His coming again.
Merry Christmas. God is with us, not distant from us. God is for us, not against us. The light of Christ surrounds us. The kindness and the love of God our Savior has appeared. This we have seen and testified to. We light this candle confident that Jesus is with us always to the very end.
Christmas has come. He is here. We are the Coimas, and this is Lombard Christian Reformed Church. It is time to worship the Lord God who comes to save.
Come, Lord Jesus, come again.
Oh, come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant.
Tell me again the Christmas story. with the halo of his glory. Halo born of humbleness, by the breath of cattle blessed, by the poverty of stall, where a bed of straw is all. By a door closed at the inn, only men of means get in. By a door closed to the poor, Christ is born on earthen floor in a stable with no lock. Yet kingdoms tremble at the shock of a king in swaddling clothes at an address no one knows. Because there is no painted sign, nothing but a star divine, nothing but a halo bright about his young head in the night. Nothing but the wondrous light of innocence that is the child, trusting all within his smile. Mary's son of golden star, wise men journey from afar. Mary's son in manger born, music of the angel's horn. Mary's son in straw and glory, wonder of the Christmas story.
Christ the King, born in a manger. Christ the King is born on this day. All creation joins the rejoicing. Banish misfortune away. Banish misfortune away. Lift your voice. Join in the singing. Lift your voice in a song of goodwill. Lift your heart to the glorious season. Bid all your sorrows be still. Bid all your sorrows be still. Christ the King, born in a manger. Christ the King is born on this day. All creation joins the rejoicing. Banish misfortune away. Banish misfortune away. Lift your voice. Join in the singing. Lift your voice in a song of goodwill. Lift your heart to the glorious season. Bid all your sorrows be still. Bid all your sorrows be still.
When God first created the world, it was good. It was very good. But then Adam and Eve disobeyed God and sin entered the world. It was a sad time. But the Bible says that God made a promise to Adam and Eve that someday all that is wrong in the world and in our hearts will be made right. That one day a child would be born and he would save us because God loves us with a never stopping, never giving up, unbreaking, always and forever love. Would you share one wonder about the world God created for which you praise the Lord?
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep. Yeah.
In the Old Testament, we read of how God was faithful to his people, the Israelites. They would disobey him and ask for forgiveness. And again and again, God forgave them and promised them that one day a Savior would be born. Because God loves us with a never stopping, never giving up, unbreaking, always and forever love. One lesson about growing up is this. Learn to say, I'm sorry and thank you. Take a moment now to confess to the Savior your sorrow over your sin. Then give thanks as you receive his forgiving mercy. God fulfilled his promise and showed his never stopping, never giving up, unbreaking, always and forever love in the birth of his Son, Jesus. Listen now to Luke 2, verses 1 through 7. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. Let me ask you, what is your favorite part of the gospel Christmas story? Share about that question together for a while.
Some Children See Him, by Wyla Hudson. Some children see him lily white, the baby Jesus born this night. Some children see him lily white, with tresses soft and fair. Some children see him bronzed and brown, the Lord of heaven to earth come down. Some children see him bronzed and brown, with dark and heavy hair. Some children see him almond-eyed, this Savior whom we kneel beside. Some children see him almond-eyed, with skin of yellow hue. Some children see him dark as they, sweet Mary's son to whom we pray. Some children see him dark as they, and ah, they love him too. The children in each different place will see the baby Jesus' face like theirs but bright, with heavenly grace and filled with holy light. O lay aside each earthly thing, and with thy heart as offering, come worship now the infant king. 'Tis love that's born tonight.
They told me, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. A newborn king to see, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. Our finest gifts we bring, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. To lay before the king, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum, rum-bum-bum-bum, rum-bum-bum-bum. So to honor him, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum, when we come. Little baby, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. I am a poor boy too, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. I have no gift to bring, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. That's fit to give a king, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum, rum-bum-bum-bum, rum-bum-bum-bum. Shall I play for you, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum, on my drum?
Jesus' birth was good news that the angels in heaven were told to share. Our Heavenly Father directed them to share it with the shepherds. Listen to how the angels told the shepherds about God's never stopping, never giving up, unbreaking, always and forever love. From Luke 2, now verses 8 through 16. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heavens, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. So now together finish this sentence. I praise Jesus for. Light the fourth candle and share together and finish that sentence.
Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Why this jubilee? Why your joyous strains prolong? Say, what may the tidings be which inspire your heavenly song? Glory.
Before Jesus was born, it was like the world was all dark. But when Jesus came, it was like a light was turned on. That's why sometimes Jesus is called the light of the world. Now even you can see God's never stopping, never giving up, unbreaking, always and forever love. Listen to these verses from John chapter 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him all things were made. Without Him nothing was made that has been made. In Him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world. And though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of a human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Light now the fifth candle, the Christ candle, and think about and share together. Can you imagine what it means to you that Jesus is your light? What does it mean to say, this little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine?
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
Luke 2:17-20. When they had seen him, They spread the word concerning what has been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Can you remember a time when you got really good news? Did you keep that news to yourself? If you're like me, you can't keep exciting news to yourself. Like the angels and the shepherds, you just have to tell someone. So here's our question. Who are you going to tell about God's never stopping, never giving up, unbreaking, always and forever love?
Chill it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching, old silent flocks by night. Behold throughout the heavens shone the holy light. Yeah, go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. The shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angel chorus that hailed the Savior's birth. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Down in the lowly manger, the humble Christ was born. And God sent us salvation, yeah, that blessed Christmas morn. Oh, go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Jesus Christ is born. Jesus Christ is born. Jesus Christ is born.
In the Gospel of Matthew, the first thing said about Jesus is who he is, Emmanuel, which means God with us. And the last thing Jesus says in the last chapter of Matthew 28 is, I am with you. Always. From the beginning to the end of Jesus' life on earth, the revelation is that God is here with us, with you, that heaven has to do with earth, that life is about more than the material and the measured. And in the Luke Christmas story, witnesses tell us the angels brought this message from God. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. A Savior born for you. The divine is physically present. He is here. See the new life born today. And some of the last things Jesus says in Luke to his wondering and worried disciples are, "Look at my hands and my feet. It is I myself. Touch me and see. A ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see I have." God is that real and that close to us. The Christmas message is that God is with us as one of us. We are made for transcendence, that is, for life with God, who graces our lives with divine love. True living attends to what is holy, even in the everyday. The mortal lives with an eye on the eternal. The pressure is on us to deny this. They say we live in a buffered age, you know. God is only in your head. They try to convince us that there is no God who governs and provides or causes what is good and suffers evil or whose grace calls and saves. A God who is actively involved in the events and wonders, mysteries, sufferings, and joys and sorrows of everyday life. They mock or even persecute those who say, "My purpose in life is to enjoy serving and giving glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit." From advertisements to popular music to TED Talks to most television and movies to oppressive governments, the message is this material world is all there is. And you and I are judged by material success, health, wealth, freedom, pleasure, and giving yourselves to these goals is how you prove that you are living an authentic, well-lived life. But here is Christmas. If you're trying to convince the skeptic that Jesus really is God, would you share a story of angels and a star and a baby born of a virgin? Not unless you are committed to telling the truth. And the truth is, a reality exists beneath and beyond what we can calculate and compute. Christmas brings this inviting feeling that we're made for something more. People still respond to the Christmas story because people are missing transcendence, connecting with the divine and the holy. Like the answer to our questions that persist in our souls. Where did I come from? And why am I here? And aren't I supposed to be getting somewhere? If people aren't missing God, they're missing the blessing of God's saving grace, the answer to the eternity that's in their hearts. They may say in public, "I don't believe in miracles," but we know everybody wants one. Now, you and me, we're used to the Christmas story, so we forget how wholly otherworldly and yet earthy it is. We forget that the first word of Christmas is not, "Isn't this cute and sweet?" but "Do not be afraid." A baby born to a virgin by the will of God. A star seen at its rising announcing the King of Kings. The idea of angels, a host of them, appearing, speaking, and being heard and believed by actual living shepherds. Of God come down to earth, of God with us. This is fantastic. A transforming of earth with divine presence and peace. Yes, God is with us. Yes, all things are in God's hand. Yes, we are meant to live in relationship with God who is present, who is the giver of all good gifts, who suffers with us in trouble, and who transforms us with his love. So real that John could write in a letter long after, that which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked at and our hands have touched, this we proclaim concerning the word of life. Can God be that real for you too? Something broken in us makes it easier for us to feel God's against us, or God doesn't care, or decide that since I have lived through more now, I know more now, so God can't be real, and that other things matter more if I'm going to make it. But the Christmas revelation endures, calling you close to the Lord. Can I help you see him this Christmas? Where might I see the Lord? I think many times the Lord is present in our ignorance. I don't mean a God of the gaps kind of understanding where we just use the term God for things we just don't know yet. But when life situations beg a deeper meaning, like, where did that darkness within me come from? How do I rid myself of it? Or why am I not satisfied? Or doesn't there have to be more? Or what's the meaning of all this? As with the shepherds, the Lord is telling us about something, about God's presence with us in Jesus. And the invitation in our ignorance is to go and see what God is telling us about. The Lord is also with us in wonder and beauty. In that moment when you really see the beauty of it all, a poetic phrase, the way the music stays with you, how that math problem just works. And even in the simple sacredness of a newborn, and all of a sudden your eyes are open to the truth that this person is made in the image of God. It is like Mary pondering all these things, treasuring them up after travel and the anxious moments and the strange surroundings, the shepherds and angels and all, and a Savior born, a baby, to treasure these wondrous and beautiful things in her heart. Gratitude helps us sense the Father too, to stop and notice the good gift and not only enjoy it, but recognize this grace given to you by the hand of the Lord. For every good gift comes from the hand of the Father. How else do I sense God with me, loving and being loved too? That's a way, and even in trouble. And there you hear the assurance, do not be afraid. You hear the calling home and all that makes us feel we're not home yet. His presence is also received by true and holy moments of assurance. Rest in prayer and in word and in sacrament. As real as the sound of a baby's first cry, as genuine as our need for hope, peace, joy, and love, the angels announce it. He is here. The shepherds see him and are amazed. He is right there. It is how you and I are to live our lives. He's right here with me. I know at times beyond our ability to grasp by mere human experience, but yet so real into the depths of who we are and what we're made for. If you attend to these graces, your heart and soul will open so that you know Jesus is given for you to know and love, even as you are known and loved by Him. And may you experience His presence, and may that presence transform you today. Amen. He is here, the Savior has been born, the one we've waited for, surrounded by our praises. He is here, the promise of the King. To you our lives we bring, let your glory be revealed. Joy to the world, peace to all who love Him. The Savior has been born, and all of heaven smiles. Glory to God, we bring an offering to you. Join with all the angels singing Alleluia. He is here, the Savior has been born. The one we've waited for, surrounded by our praises. He is here, the promise of the King. To you our lives we bring, let your glory be revealed. Joy to the world, peace to all who love Him. The Savior has been born, and all of heaven smiles. Glory to God, we bring an offering to you. Join with all the angels singing Alleluia, Alleluia. He is here, Alleluia. He is here.
Today's offering is for Roseland Christian Ministries, which operates a number of ministries, including a food pantry, a thrift store, and a shelter for women and children in the Roseland neighborhood. Please pray with me. Heavenly Father, we thank you for Roseland Christian Ministries and for the work that they do in serving those in need. Please bless their work this holiday season and help them to have enough funding and volunteers during this time. Please bless the offering we collect today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Long lay the world.
Merry Christmas, sisters and brothers. May you be filled with the wonder of Mary, the obedience of Joseph, the joy of the angels, the witness of the shepherds, the determination of the Magi, and the peace of the Christ child. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless us now and forever. Amen.